In this video, we're going to look at annotating a plot using the ANNO menu. This is useful because it allows you to highlight or call attention to different parts of the plot that might be interesting. This is brought to you by the Science of Flight. Let's get to it. In this video, we're going to look at annotating a plot in Xfoil. The ANNO menu, that's A-N-N-O, is used for marking up the different Xfoil plots with text, symbols, lines, and arrows. Now, I went ahead and I recopied Xfoil's menu hierarchy here, the idea being you can see just how accessible this ANNO menu is from different parts of Xfoil. The reason, of course, is because these different menus work on the different plots. You are not able to use ANNO on every single plot that Xfoil makes, but you're able to use it on most. For instance, the paneling plot, you're not able to actually annotate. Even though this menu is located in different parts of the menu hierarchy, when you access it, it is the same menu. For that reason, I'm just going to use menu name, where I would typically put the actual menu that we were dealing with. To access the annotation menu, just type ANNO in the command prompt. That's A-N-N-O, and hit enter. When you do that, you will see that it will pop up with this mini menu showing you the different commands, the command descriptions, and of course giving you a prompt where you can select what annotation you want to put onto your plot. The commands are the first letter of the actual options you have. So if I was wanting to put in a math character onto my plot, I would type an M at the command prompt and hit enter. Xfoil will separate the commands that you can use on this menu into plot and modify. Plot commands will actually put something onto the plot, whether that's a point or a line or a string of text, whereas the modify commands are there to modify the different plot commands. For instance, I could change the symbol of the points, or I can change the size of what is actually put onto the plot with those two there. The first two plot commands that you see is characters and slant characters. These commands allow you to choose the location on the plot that you are wanting the text to be displayed, and then type in the string of text that you're wanting to display as the message. The difference between characters and slant characters is that the slant characters is italicized. As you can see by the text I copied over from Xfoil, when I choose one of these commands, it's going to ask me to click on the lower left point of the character string where it's supposed to place the text. After you go ahead and identify the location, it will then ask you for the text of the message. Type it in and hit enter. I went ahead and added small red X's to show you approximately where I clicked for the text to be generated where it's at. Now, both of these are really good at identifying properties of the graph or making quick notes about the graph, maybe an interpretation of what you see in the graph. The next plot command would be math characters. I went ahead and typed in the alphabet, both lowercase, uppercase, and the symbols available on a typical keyboard for you to see what is actually generated. And I use the arrows to point out which line of math characters corresponds to which line of text I entered. As you can see with the math characters, it gives us access to many of the Greek letters that are often used in engineering, both lowercase and uppercase. Some of the math characters are different from the string of text that we entered to create them. The next object that we have to mark up our plots is a point symbol. This gives us the option to select a specific point on the plot that we want to draw attention to. there are 14 different point symbols that we can use, and one of the modify commands is actually used to change the point symbol that will be put on the plot when we use the point symbol command. I went ahead and ran through each of the different point symbols so you can see what symbol is printed when you use that type of point symbol. The first column is on the first row and the second column's on the second row, and they just go in order. Now the last two of the plot commands are pretty similar, so I'm going to cover them both at the same time. The first is line and the second is arrow. The way that these work is that when you start a line, it will continue to add lines everywhere that you click, and to get it to stop doing that, you need to double click on the last point. Now, as you can see on the plot here on the right, I went ahead and just clicked around to show you what I mean by that. Every time I clicked, it would draw a line between the last point I clicked and the current point I clicked, and then it would wait for the next point I clicked, and it just continues to do this until I double click and say I'm done creating line, and then that's it. With the arrow, that's the point where it's going to add the arrowhead. It does not have one at the beginning, the first place that you click, but it will put it at the last point that you click. I went ahead and did an example of why something like this might be useful down here at the bottom, where I just randomly chose a spot to mark as a transition point. So what I used was an arrow, and I did a multi-segment arrow. So I clicked next to the text that I just put there using the character command. And then I clicked in the middle point you see there at the bend, and then I clicked really close to the airfoil. This is just a nice way to be able to mark up a point on the plot where you might have text located at a distance from the point that you're wanting to draw attention to. The last thing on this menu is the other modify command, the description being width of characters. Now, width of characters is a little bit misleading. It should really be size of text or size of characters. So I went ahead and did a demonstration here where you can see the default text size and default point there towards the top. And then I changed the width of characters from 1 to 3. And as you can see by the text, it greatly increased the size. This command also works not just on the characters, slant characters, math characters, but it also works on the point symbol, and it will work on the arrow as well. It will change the size of the arrowhead at the end of the line. All right, we're going to go ahead and end the video here. In this video, we talked about marking up the different plots that Xfoil generates with text, with characters, with lines and arrows. If you haven't already, go ahead, like the video, comment below, and subscribe to the channel. I know that these things aren't really important to the Google algorithm they have going nowadays, but it's definitely important to me. It lets me know that there's interest not only in this channel, but maybe this series. So go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, and let me know that this is value added to you. If there's perhaps a different series that you'd like to see in the aerospace engineering field, feel free to let me know. But for now, remember, it's just rocket science. I'll see you in the next video.